I was never going to be a man's physique.
Didn't have much of an off season.
I like his physique better.
I'm always very energetic.
I will have to put me as one of the greatest.
Mr. Olympia was won by the back.
Do you think, you know, the wheelchair bodybuilding can grow bigger even? And, you know, obviously you're already on the biggest stage, but I'm talking about more, it becomes more popular, more people get involved. You know what I mean? Like, do you see it as growing actually in the future?
Yeah, I see it growing, because what it is, it's not if, but when, because like I'm friends with many of the promoters. Like if say like eventually when this does expand, it's easy to expand it to like the Arnold Australia, Arnold Brazil, because I'm friends with those promoter. It's just trying to get all the athletes in a financial situation. So, but as this goes, it's like a popularity thing, but also like it's all about social media and the platforms. As you know, you do a phenomenal job at that too. So it's kind of like, I want to make sure that there's tons of pictures and videos out there, so it slowly water ripples, because one person shares it, and then before you know it, it just gets out there, and you know, and eventually, look, here we are today, because you're aware of it probably from the Arnold, the Olympia, or you're seeing something besides me.
No, for sure. That's actually a good point. Financially, like even regular bodybuilding, right? You know, just men's open, you know, it's not the most lucrative sport. You know, we know that obviously. You know, and then as it goes down from there, you know, men's physique, classic physique, they're all getting much less money, obviously, right? Unless they have good sponsors. So for wheelchair, I mean, do you see it being lucrative in the future? Like, meaning that prize money go up, and also actual sponsorships. Do you think sponsors look out for, you know, disabled bodybuilders or wheelchair bodybuilders to sponsor them?
So how it comes, so right now it's like trying to get these guys to compete, to build a platform so they can go out and get sponsorships to pay for flights, hotels, and expenses, or get a check. Because I've had all types of sponsorships over the years where it's, you know, the direct deposit, all expenses paid, photo shoots, I've had all that stuff. So I know the mindset, what it is, but they have to go out and get it. So as for this, the prize money, that just depends on like how the sport grows, because if I can't, like for years, like had no sponsorship. So how did the prize money? It was just me signing checks. So
no, I get it.
In the beginning, at all the pro shows, there's a minimum of 6,000 that I'll give out. So it's like a 3-2-1, 3,000 for first place, 2,000 for second, 1,000 for third. But then at certain ones that I'll pay for more, pay for less, because it all comes out of pocket. Because a lot of stuff, I'm a professional speaker, so I go and I speak, and then I take care of that. But when you put on like, you know, 2, 3, 4 pro shows a year, that's, you know, it's expensive.
Absolutely.
Some of those first place awards are in the 4 digits, but most people don't look at that either, because everything adds up from a financial standpoint. But if the sport wants to grow, that's where it's like, and get out there, if like companies want to get more involved and donate, then I'll be able to do more, give more prize money, or put on more pro shows. It just really depends on, again, how well this evolves with time. But I'm not going to stop. I'm going to keep growing the sport and make it to the next level.